Hey, survivor of the apocalypse, this is Paul Sadin. Hey, did you know that this season you're going to decide how this show ends? You gotta be a patron to do that. Head on over to patreon.com/atheistapocalypse. Become a patron, subscribe to whatever level you feel comfortable with, and know that in a couple weeks, we're going to ask you how you want all of this to end. So please go make sure you tell us what you want. Now, let's get into the show.
This is Jake from KUSA 9 News at 9, and this episode is sponsored by Bad Bunny, providing custom clothes, lingerie, and accessories for badasses. Each item is artist-made start to finish, from the design of the fabric or pattern, to the handmade creation of designs like the dinosaur bone undies, unicorn pasties, teeth print dresses, and a ton more. Bad Bunny is here to fulfill your need for unique, spooky, creepy, sexy, and nerdy handmade fashion. The Bad Bunny herself offered up 5% for you survivors. Just enter the coupon code UNCHOSEN at checkout. Find her shop at Etsy.com/shop/Bad Bunny Shop. On Facebook at Facebook.com/Bad Bunny Art. And on Instagram at Bad Bunny Shop.
Hello, this is Matthew the Apostle from In the Name of God, the podcast. And you are hearing my voice right now because I survived the apocalypse. This is good news for you as well, because now you can rest assured that I will chronicle the next theocratic crime wave.
Welcome to Atheist Apocalypse, a fictional comedy podcast for reason. All of the characters you are about to meet are fictional and do not represent real people. Except when they do. Either way, we welcome you to the show and would like to encourage you to head over to atheistapocalypse.com for more information about the show, as well as details on how you can contribute to help keep the lights on. After all, this is the apocalypse. And we could definitely use all the help we can get. Thank you.
Good evening, listeners. I'm Jake Leminski, and this is KUSA 9 News at 9, your local authority. Joining me for yet another broadcast, because she doesn't understand the meaning of the word vacation, is Beatrice Johnson. Good evening, Beatrice. I hope all is well with you.
It is, thank you. I'm thrilled to be here again and thrilled to announce that we've received a mysterious letter in the mail right before coming on air.
I don't like the sound of that. The last time we received a mysterious letter right before the broadcast, we discovered the rapture was the cause of all the good lot of people disappearing. I hope this missive isn't related to that. Maybe it'll explain why the initial statement was wrong, and that some of us were left here intentionally to handle any unfinished business.
Not exactly, Jake. This letter, laid out carefully in letters clipped from old newspapers, is about old Jake. It reads, KUSA 9 News at Night Authorities. It is unconscionable to think someone could be worse than Jake Lemmingstein, your old anchor everyone seems to have forgotten about. But your HR department seems bound and determined to hire the most unfavorable scum that Tri-Counties has to offer. Though Jake Lemmingstein is safe, the same may not necessarily be true for Jake Leminski for much longer. That guy is the worst. Don't worry about me running out of space. Expanding the walls is my problem to figure out. Signed, be warned. Well, Jake, looks like you've made a friend. On a positive note, it appears that Jake Lemmingstein is alive and well, and this news is more than we've heard from our own sheriff's department.
This mysterious letter writer better not cross paths with me. I'm well versed in Kung Tao, and the last person I had to apply its techniques to, they didn't fare so well. The memories, what I did, still haunt my dreams.
and my reality has proven a true waking nightmare since. My instructor said it wasn't my fault, but it was just so gruesome. His eyes. The fear in his eyes.
Okay. Well, the political realm is becoming equally gruesome as more and more candidates move to the Tri-Counties in order to establish residency and qualify to run for office. Undeterred by calls of bandwagoneers and being a fair-weather seaman, scores of politicians from across every conceivable party have put their name on the upcoming ballot, which should make this election cycle very interesting.
Most definitely. Seeing as many Americans aren't sure how to research their political candidates, preferring the passive absorption technique of accepting 30-second soundbites from political campaign ads during their preferred news channel's public lashing of opposition parties, people will now be responsible for their own research in order to make the decision that best aligns with what they'd like to see in the world.
One has to be concerned about what this means for actually educated voters.
Trust me, Beatrice. Nothing motivates Americans like having their interests threatened. If anything, this election cycle might be remembered as the election where voters actually cared enough to read up on the candidates' positions on important issues, where they actually made informed decisions.
Which brings us to our breaking news. If listeners want to become educated on their candidates, they'll now have one less day each week to do so, as the mysterious government entity has announced that the internet will be shut down on Sundays. More reminiscent of North Korea rather than the northern part of our state, the internet will be inaccessible to everyone for the entirety of each Sunday, starting this upcoming weekend. As expected, officials at the MGE haven't provided any more details than we've just reported, but as soon as we get them, we'll be sure to relay them to you. But before we do anything else, let's take you to entertainment news, because if there's anything more important to the American public than sports, it's pop culture relevancy. Take it away, Edwin.
Thank you, Beatrice and Jake. It's me, Edwin Bonshift, your insider to Hollywood news. People who would once call at odd hours to talk about their problems, but now hurriedly pass you off to their assistant once they recognize your voice. Paul Walker III, father of Fast and Furious actor Paul Walker, has filed a wrongful death lawsuit against Porsche, almost exactly 2 years to the day of his son's demise in a 2005 Porsche Carrera GT that slammed into a tree. Walker III alleges that the vehicle was lacking in vital safety. I never understood why buses don't have seatbelts. I was on my way to audition for a role in Inception. It was nothing big, mind you. It was supposed to be the guy all the characters were in the dreams of. I had lines and, well, the bus slammed on its brakes, swerving to avoid another LA high-speed chase. And I banged my head against the seat in front of me and the lines, they were gone. Anyway, Ice-T, talk show host, rapper, and father, welcomed his daughter, Chanel, into the world. Mother Coco posted a photo of the child on Instagram. Surprise! Look who came early, wrote Coco. Welcome to the new arrival of Chanel. I never even went to the audition. I was too embarrassed. I couldn't even make it to the soundstage to actually audition. I just went home, got in my hoodie-footy pajamas, and went to bed. John Stamos, known for his roles in Grandfathered and Full House, pled no contest to one misdemeanor charge of driving under the influence in Los Angeles. Originally facing 6 months in prison, he is now sentenced to 3 years of probation and a year's worth of AA media. I went on a bit of a bender after that. I'd never missed an audition before. I came back to weeks of piled up messages and a letter stating that my agent had dropped me. I found another one quickly, because there are a dime a dozen in that scene, and got back to work. But I never got another shot at a Nolan feature. Look at that, it's my time. That's all from what's left of Hollywood from me, Edwin Bonshift, here at KUSA 9 News at 9. Back to you, Jake. There's no way I could possibly call them again.
Thanks for whatever that was, Edwin. Sounds like you might want to consider entertaining that little drinking problem of yours again. You've got some demons to drown. In equally pressing news, remember when everyone was whining about the spider infestation?
don't think it's fair to say people were whining, Jake.
It doesn't matter what you think, Beatrice. You're a reporter. Your job is to stick to the facts.
I will cut you!
Anyway, we all remember the devastating yet overstated impact the spider infestation had on our region throughout the late summer and fall last year. With everyone clamoring for the destruction of harmless spiders, no one noticed that legislation had been slipped past the MGE that outlawed utilities charging for water consumption by Tri-County residents. As of 5 p.m. today, local time, this bill went into law and now water is completely free, thanks to the championing of the issue by Lowell Deludery. French guy, a former pastor and now lifelong school board president.
While many are celebrating this as a victory for the common person... Others aren't convinced that Mr. Deludier simply wasn't leveraging this issue in order to garner support for his run at the office. In fact, with the Tri-Counties being overrun with new political candidates, one must worry about seats even at this level being filled with purported allies of the MGE.
Now, Beatrice, that's mere speculation. There are absolutely no ties between Mr. Deluder and the MGE, and he won. In a landslide, I might add, because he cares about his fellow man, the common man. Stop trying to make an issue out of something that isn't.
I'm not.
Shatid, I can only count to six. What the heck come after six? I'm Shatid, I'm definitely not Asian. I'm Shatid, and I've seen God. I'm Shatid, and I do a black flip. I'm Shatid, and I burned down a hospital. I'm Shatid, and I'm immune to AIDS. I'm Shatid, and I don't believe in gravity. I'm Shatid, and I'm Shatid, and not a mini basement.
Well, it seems that whatever Beatrice was going to contribute to the discussion wasn't going to be impactful. So let's transition to our international correspondent, Fabrice Le Chevalier. Welcome, Fabrice. It's been a refreshingly long time since we last spoke. We're skipping your top five list today, not because no one enjoys them. It's because I don't enjoy them.
Meh, I still get paid for appearing, so...
Oh, Jake... Don't treat our very special guest like that. Welcome, Fabrice. It's so great to have you back again.
Merci, mademoiselle. I am very happy to join you again.
We're so glad you did. I
wanted to get any information you may have on Lowell Deludier, who recently was a local pastor and now seems to be the most influential school board president in... well, in the history of the world.
And why do you think I would know anything about this person?
Because you're French. And his last name is French. I mean, it's not rocket surgery here, Fabrice.
You cannot be serious, sir. This is why you called me on? Do you know what time it is in Paris right now? You don't want to discuss the spreading panic across Europe, especially in England, from the chaos resulting from the rapture? You don't want to discuss how uninformed the English are because they refuse to listen to your broadcast. You don't even want to discuss the rumors traveling along the underbelly of Europe as to why those who were selected in the rapture were selected, and that this might not be the end of the rapture event. You don't want to hear any of those things because you think I might have some insight into an American preacher turned politician because his name may or not be French?
Pastor.
Quoi?
He was a pastor, not a preacher.
I'm sorry, Fabrice. I told Jake this was a bad idea and that we should leverage the short time we get with you for those types of insights you mentioned, but he ran off to station management for approval and they wouldn't listen to me.
You, my dear, have nothing to apologize for. I understand your struggle against the misogyny in American culture. You should consider coming to Paris. I can help you get a job with...
Weird how that call just dropped. Probably because of the inadequacies of those foreign phone providers. If it were American like Sprint, no call would ever be dropped. This segment was brought to you by Sprint. We may not have the biggest network, and we sure don't have the most dependable network, but hey, we've got a few antennas, you've got a phone that may or may not be compatible. Why don't we make like Zelda and link up? Sprint, when you're too cheap for good coverage. Oh well, We tried to bring insight no one else can, but sometimes even KUSA 9 News at 9 cannot overcome problematic technology. As the saying goes here at KUSA, when in doubt, blame Tyler. Now, let's get over to the extraterrestrial weather before Beatrice makes a scene.
Greetings, humanoids. It appears some of you are unable to reach the web due to Hitler-esque laws by the MGE. Of course, you wouldn't be having this problem if you were accepted into the bunkers. We have direct access to the deep web.
That's right, folks. We have some of the top area Bigfoot hunters, alien experts, and elite hacksaws. We have 23 terabytes of deep web content, history, and Discovery Channel documentaries at our fingertips.
Our one failing is alcohol. The first few subjects of our initial batch of Shine have gone, well, partially blind.
But fear not for these people. They have gone from being lowly test subject to being transferred to our pre-cog research division. With one of their senses dulled, they may be able to see into the future.
I really don't understand what happened. I've watched every episode of Moonshiners. Rye whiskey, please don't let me down. Gonna take me a drink, then I'll roam around. Check all my stills and see if they're okay. Rye whiskey, please last all day. I don't wanna run out of my whiskey today. I won't have no more, that's what they'll say. Rye whiskey, please don't let me down.
I think the bunker and all the moonshine failures have really had an impact on Andy. Tyler, send us some craft beers. The sourest ones you can find. Please. And food. He won't let any of us leave.
What are you whispering?
Nothing, bro. Over to you, Jake.
Interesting developments over there, gentlemen. Turning back to the news on Lowell Deluder and his appointment as school board president for life, we understand that the margin of victory for Mr. Deluder and his win over Toby McClellan, the margin of victory for the French guy over the Irish guy was 85%. He utterly mutilated his opponent, and Sheriff Roger Rogers has stated that the investigation is closed and Lowell will not be formally charged. Whether or not he was the driving force behind the Free Water Act that provides completely free, potable, and non-potable water to the tri-counties really doesn't matter. It got him elected. That's the money shot.
Jesus, Jake.
May this be the first of many great accomplishments he achieves during his time as school board president for life. Now that we have the weight of responsibility lifted from our shoulders, let's talk spirits. Chakra. Whatever it is that Venice talks about.
Hello, my lovelies. You've caught me in the middle of a soiree, but I just had to take a few moments and write to you all. Things are hopping here at the penthouse. I'm hosting a chakra balancing party, and all the right people are here. Even better, since this is the first Sunday with no internet, everyone is actually paying attention to their chakras. The vibrations are so wonderful. Even Horace is in a better mood and is even being somewhat nice to Gary for the time being. Everyone is here, Yogi Brahma and his cute blonde friend, Biff, Cosmia, Mystic Mini, and everyone from the yoga studio. It's a triumph of an event. Yogi Brahma has found the most unique way to balance our chakras. Now that water is free, he commissioned an enormous waterbed. The thing is just massive. And the roof of the penthouse was the only place that we could build it comfortably. So, Gary had some friends come and put it all together. He even got nice velvet bumper edges all the way around. So, we're all sitting on the giant waterbed, trying not to knock anyone else off. And trying not to knock anyone else off with the waves of our motion. It's quite a challenge, I must say. One wrong move, and an entire side of the circle could go flying off the edge. I've had to banish Anja from the roof, as we just got settled into a nice coming wave a while ago, and he jumped right into the middle of the circle. The resulting wave even for a little doggy like Anja, was enough to send Yogi Brahma's cute blonde friend sailing over the side. It was frightening, to say the least. I'm thinking we may have to put netting around the edge, like they do with trampolines, just to make sure there aren't any injuries. Ooh, they've started the chanting, and Cosmia has her crystal ball ready. I'd better put this laptop down and pay attention. Until next time, my lovelies, remember that the truth is whatever makes you happy, and reality is whatever we believe it to be. Namaste.
Thank you, Venice. I think. Listeners, we've received confirmation that you will not, I repeat, not have internet access on Sundays according to the MGE. Laptops, tablets, smart TVs, and smartphones will all cease providing a channel to the rest of the world. When asked why the MGE made such a dramatic decision, the cloudy and eerily iridescent representative went silent, preferring to act out a skit of a mime being trapped in a box, before announcing to the gathered group of reporters and opinionated yet clearly not professionally trained bloggers that a new program had been launched by the MGE.
The ever-shifting apparition stated the new program is called the Oneness Initiative, and, as the name implies, it is designed to create a peaceful, homogeneous, and anesthetized community here in the Tri-Counties. A worrying comment indeed.
Well, not if you're a critical thinker, Beatrice. The fact is that the Tri-Counties finds itself in chaos because of the amount of dissent espoused by its residents. For quite some time, we've needed something that could bring us all together, and it appears that growing pressure from the upcoming elections has made the MGE act before another party rises to popular power.
And this is their solution?
Oneness, Beatrice? Really? You view harmonious and peaceful cohabitation as a bad thing?
No, I...
Hey guys, we just got word that the counties are bone dry.
What are you talking about, Tyler? That doesn't even make sense. I mean, this is an arid region of the country, especially at this time of year. But bone dry? Don't you think you're being a little extreme? Are you not getting enough attention from Beatrice already?
All the alcohol is gone.
All the alcohol is gone? What does that even mean?
It's exactly what it sounds like. In case you didn't notice, and you probably didn't, the bill that was just passed by the MGE, which shuts down the internet on Sundays, also happened to wipe away those archaic and provincial blue laws that bar alcohol purchases on Sundays. So, naturally, people bum-rushed every outlet in the country. We are drier than a nun in the Mojave. So, I hope you weren't planning on having any beer at the house for that huge party you were throwing this weekend that... pretty much no one was going to attend, Jake.
You've got to be kidding me. My party was going to be off the hook.
No,
best not to say anything more on it. Let's just get over to sports before you embarrass yourself further. Take it away, whoever our current sports person is.
Yeah, apparently Artie was cleared by HR to come back on some sort of semi-permanent basis. He didn't sound too good when I talked to him, but he gave me permission to record a sports segment while we were on the phones.
That's great. Cue up that clip.
Do you not care about Artie's condition at all?
Meh, not really. Take it away.
Oh, sweet Midian, I burn for thee at heart. Don't despair me. Come bear me on wings of graveyard rub leather, to where pleasure rings deep secrets and spirits after dark. We stand armed and dangerous before the bloody fields of history, devoid of dogma, but ready to carve, to defy the transient, ready to stab forth with our penetrative will, strain every leash, run yelling down the mountainside of man, ready and willing to immolate world upon world with our stunning blaze, and let them all sing that we were here as masters among the failing species called man, our being took form in defiance to stand before your killing gaze. And now we travel from flame to flame and tower from the will to the glory. Agios, O Baphomet. Agios, O Baphomet.
Great. Now can you just take your pills, sweetie?
Good old Artie. Back to his... whatever the hell he was before. I wonder what kind of pills he's getting. I mean, not that I need pills. You know what? Never mind. It doesn't matter. Because now we head over to the ever-popular Rick Beckley to bring us his latest from the field.
Whoa, this isn't real, is it?
What isn't real?
That alcohol is now illegal on Sundays?
No, big guy. Totally legal.
Well, Catholics still do that whole blood of Jesus wine stuff on Sundays, right?
As far as I know.
Hello, Catholicism.
Why?
Because they still get to drink on Sundays?
No one should be this stupid.
What?
Nothing. Anyways, according to station management, the internet is banned on Sundays.
What? This is an outrage.
I didn't think you'd take it all that hard.
How else is the world supposed to know what I'm doing on Sundays?
And how would they know anyways?
I'm kind of a big deal on Twitter. I have upwards of 11 very loyal followers on there. If they don't get their daily dose of Rick, well, that's a frightening prospect. They may even riot.
I don't think 11 is all that much.
Well, I'm sure it was much closer to 800 or 900 before the disappearances.
Anyways, let's do the story so we can get out of here. Tyler and I have a project we need to stay late for.
Fine. Is this thing on?
Rick, all the equipment is always on. I show up 3 hours earlier than you to every single field report we do. Haven't you noticed that you never have to get anything ready?
Nope. Anyways, good evening, Tri-Counties. This is your beloved Rick Beckley standing in my driveway. Only because I didn't know where else to do a story like this.
A bar would have been nice.
Sarah, can we try to use some professionalism here? Anyways, it appears that alcohol is now illegal on Sundays. And more important, I'm afraid that the internet is also banned.
How did he ever graduate from journalism school?
This will come to a terrible blow to my 11 Twitter followers. But fear not, I will be back on Mondays. As much as you want to riot, remember, it is not worth it. I mean, I am, of course, but the trouble you will surely get yourself into isn't. This is probably just some tactic by the Kardashians to gain some of my followership. I'll be looking into that, dear faithful. Don't you worry.
Oh, Jesus.
Until we hear anything else, dear fan base, this has been Rick Beckley, KUSA 9, News at 9, saving the world, one story at a time. Studio.
You know, each time Rick Beckley comes on the air, I question my career decisions.
Rude. Rick Beckley is class. Capital C, capital L, capital ass. Class.
Mm-hmm. Anyway, it's time to check in with Venice's mailbag.
Thank you, Beatrice. Let's get into the mailbag quickly before sending you back to the only sensible person, besides me, at the studio. Musical foibles. No, dear, that's Yanni. A yoni is something very different. Flamboyant flagella. That was very rude of them to try and reduce you to a mere pittance of your basic parts. I'm glad you told them that you will refuse to work that way. Just don't let them know you can, or they will figure out you weren't designed. Wrecking Ball Babe, you lost your sledgehammer where? Oh my, I don't think it was designed for that. I imagine it will stop shaking in a couple of days. Just take some time off and let it rest. It's all yours, Beatrice.
Thanks again, Venice. Yeah, so this great plan of Lowell Deludier seems to have already backfired on the community.
What are you talking about? His plan is airtight. He insured me, in an off-air interview, that there were absolutely no holes in his plan.
Be that as it may, it appears the Tri-Counties are bone dry in more than just the alcohol department. According to reports flooding into the news desk, our reservoir is empty. Completely empty. Apparently, giving everyone access to free water as a right has blown up in the faces of the people who support it. Within hours of passing the bill, residents across the counties washed every vehicle known to humankind, watered their lawns until they were forest green, and filled garages and crawl spaces with enough backup water to ensure they survived the next apocalypse, all to the tune of sucking each other dry. If it wasn't obvious before, and obviously it wasn't, we've just had it proven to us again that anytime you completely remove price points in the name of rights, the human race is prone to abusing anything it can. Fortunately, this time it was only life-sustaining water that was abused, thanks to the completely selfish nature of the human race. Have I mentioned how much I love living here?
Aww, and we're glad to have you too, Bee.
Listen, I'm sure there is a fix for this. Anyone who follows politics knows our government can be leaned on in time of great need. Just look at the rain tax that was a rider in the new law. Unnoticed to the multitudes, this new rain tax, where you are now being taxed on your property's potential rainfall collection total, will surely sustain the Tri-Counties through any environmental disaster brought on by the all-too-predictable human abuse of the planet. So no worries, residents of the Tri-Counties. You may not have any water today to cook or to bathe or even replenish your dehydrated body with. But I'm sure our officials are already acting to save our lives. This really isn't that big of a
That's
deal.
That's a completely irresponsible thing
This broadcast
to say.
Was also brought to you by Willie's Wings, a cornerstone of the Tri-Counties for 14 generations. Willie's Wings was there from the beginning, providing the spiciest wings and waitresses in the area. You and the boys looking to vent some frustrations after a week of listening to your kids whine and your wife complain about not having enough money to spend on those shoes? Internet-free Sundays depriving you of your God-given right to see young, plump, fleshy pounds of mounds? Well, don't despair. Willie's Wings has 42 locations around the Tri-Counties. Because really, what else is there to do around here? In a hurry? Willie has just launched a brand new grab-and-go option. Have one of our voluptuous waitresses deliver right to your car while you're parked in our convenient, covered lot to provide the right level of privacy for your discretional transaction. Just call ahead, 555-462-2888. Willie's Wings. Our sauce is as hot as your mom.
Well, the Oneness Initiative seems to have really gotten some results, hasn't it? Record-shattering downloads of pornography and liquor store shelves running dry. I guess nothing says togetherness more than a bunch of men slinking off to the bathroom, smartphones in tow, their favorite video queued up, while juiced-up wives quietly cry inebriated tears into their pillows.
Oneness is much different than togetherness, Beatrice. You'd do well to dictionary more often, especially as a journalist. I dictionary so hard I can alphabet forwards and backwards.
I very much doubt that.
Well, we'll just have to take this off air after the show, B. I, for one, am looking forward to what will come out of this long-term plan. This isn't the last we'll hear of the Oneness Initiative, and I believe I speak for every single God-fearing man when I say, nor should it be. Listeners, we are more than just residents of the Tri-Counties. We are communal citizens. We are neighbors. We are friends. We depend on each other, and we take comfort in knowing that dependability will be reciprocated in our moment of need. We don't do simply because doing needs to be done. No, we do because it's right. Because it is just. It is what one brother does for another, a sister to a sister. We do because in their weakest moments, they can't. We were designed to be the hand that shaped the world. This dominion, our God's dominion. Take my hand, brothers and sisters, and always remember, stay calm, and calm we shall stay.
The Atheist Apocalypse Podcast is a Paul Sandy production. You can find more information and links to support the show's Patreon campaign at www.atheistapocalypse.com. Today's episode was written and edited by Paul Sading, Brian Bristol, Jeff Vanutsis, Jay Crawford, Deborah McTaggart, Stephen Bateman, and Dan Cocola. It was produced by Brian Bristol. Music and sounds were created by Jason Camo of A Lost State of Mind, which you can find at alostateofmind.com. All artwork you can enjoy on our YouTube channel was created by Lucy D. All studio logos were created by Greenlight Creative Design and Communications Studio. You can find more information at greenlightstudio.co. The voice of Venice was Donna Schell, creator and host of the Big Chesticles podcast. The voice of Artie's nurse was Kelly Bristol. Fabrice was played by Joseph Schomberg. You can find him at his blog, thepromenader.blogspot.com. Be sure to like us on Facebook at facebook.com/atheistapocalypsepodcast. And follow us on Twitter at AApodcastShow. We would like to thank each and every one of you who supports the show to keep it alive and well, which is more than we can say about this post-apocalyptic world we have created for you.
ZYXWVUTSRQPONMLKJIHFEDCBA. Boom!
In your face, B!